Well, the pleasure is mine to be right in front of you today. It's been long, the international break and all of that. Last year was boring, last year was interesting. I gotta watch England take it on Andorra. Not one I really wanted to watch, actually. But here I am to give you the best of Premier League updates. So, starting off today, out of importance, although just one team is actually important, I'm talking of no other than new owners. My class, we call it Saudi Funds Newcastle. Tottenham look like an inferior team to most people in this scenario. So Newcastle, Tottenham, another blockbuster to watch for this weekend. Head-to-head, 22 wins each and 8 draws, so it's a big one. Anybody who wins at it once more, it's going to add one more to his tally. Not forgetting that Tottenham have lost the last 2 away games, so there's a big risk coming into this one. Now, forgetting that Tottenham, any game they play against a team in the danger zone, one of the last 18 have they lost. But that loss, unfortunately, came to the Magpies. And not forgetting, the Magpies have conceded the most goals this season. That is where the Saudi funds have to look at this season, mostly in their defense. So, talking about Tottenham as well, they've lost the last 2 away games by an average score of 3 goals. So, next on the list is Manchester United versus Leicester. Leicester wasn't much of a good day in the game against Everton, but I'm sure Rafael Benitez went home satisfied. Leicester are looking forward to 3 consecutive wins against Manchester United since 1901. That is pre-World War I, so that is some really, really, really long time ago. So also, Leicester are winless in their last 4 league games. So really one that both teams look forward to bounce back on their feet. So let's call the famous, but not your favorite, because it doesn't involve your favorite teams. It does involve one favorite team that involves no other than the Bees. So I'm talking about Chelsea versus Brentford. Also, I say Brentford versus Chelsea. New stadium, new team in the Premier League, new challenge for Chelsea. So big something, one surely shouldn't miss. Now this is going to be the first meeting since 1946. That was after the World War I, although Chelsea won both games last season. That didn't come as a shocker to me. Last time Chelsea played Brentford, last 2 times actually, I actually ended with a squad grade of 4-0. And this is one of the closest London derby you might want to see, less than 10 kilometers away at Stamford Bridge and the Bees. National Stadium, whatever it is. So, 7 kilometers to be actually precise. Not forgetting that the Bees have a 78 win percentage against the league leaders. This doesn't also precisely doesn't cover the league. It does cover the EFL. That's the championship. So Brentford have really been a good team when it comes to beating the league leaders. So 78%. Chelsea should really watch out because Thomas Frank is one he's not here to smile. Not forgetting that the Bees have only trailed so far this season in 25 minutes. So that means, like the name of my classmate reminded me, that's David Raya. Looks like a Bollywood star, has been really doing his job thoroughly. So next on the list is Manchester City versus Burnley. Manchester City versus Burnley. This game is, let's say, boring to watch because it's just going to be one side of the field. But last 4 times that this game has ended, 5-0 Manchester City, I repeat again, 5-0. Last 8 in all competitions have ended by an aggregate score of 30 goals to 1. So Burnley really need to watch out for this details because Manchester City have some fire. I also see Phil Foden getting another chance this weekend. Maybe ahead of Jack Grealish, but chance of that happening is also really, really, really small. So not also forgetting Burnley have the longest win. They haven't won a game in our top 4 ties of football. They have the longest winless run. That's the word, winless run in top all 4 tiers of English football. So really, really something the manager should watch out for. But you know, Manchester City, another team that you want to play, especially when having this record, especially like Sean Dyche, not the best manager when it comes to playing Pep Guardiola. So, next on my list, I got Liverpool Watford. But not one I'm really interested in. I see that Liverpool winning, but if you remember, Watford trashed Liverpool 3-0. Although Liverpool still won the title, they won the title confidently that same season. Next is Everton West Ham. Everton most win, most goals scored in Premier League history have been against West Ham. So this is no joke. David Moyes really needs to cut to the chase and have a definite aim that he's going to have coming into this game. Everton, like I said earlier, had his fulfilled week. That is the word, fulfilled week. And the 1-1 draw they played at Manchester United. So Everton, West Ham won, surely, to look out for. So here's going to be a super reunion, Patrick Vieira and the Emirates. So Patrick Vieira is going to return to the Emirates, but not in the sky he wanted. It's going to be with the Eagles. The Eagles have been better. Yeah, passes, anything that statistic-wise has been better than the old style fashion of Roy Hudson. So Patrick Vieira, passing accuracy, defending, shooting, the possession style, the change, everything has been totally different. But not forgetting Arsenal Everton last meeting was 1-1. It looked like a draw to 90 minutes, but Nicolas Pepe and Gabriel Martinelli were the villains, the biggest villains in that game. So considering all games, Newcastle Tottenham must get a win, or most likely score is a draw. Manchester United versus Leicester. I see Manchester United winning by a merit. Manchester City Burnley, do not ask me about that, because Manchester City are definitely going to trash Burnley. Chelsea will play Brentford. I see that ending in a draw because of Thomas Frank does. I think it's the Harry Potter of nowadays. So which other game that I mentioned? Everton West Ham, surely to end in a draw. But if you feel anything about this, you can comment in the section below. Do not forget, you can share this video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, it's at Bennett Eki. Subscribe to my Instagram at Bennett Eki1. You'll be doing me a great good. Thank you.